We call that as model studies of turbomachines. Okay, so model studies of the turbo machines. Fine. So when I speak of model, these model studies mean the use of non-dimensional parameters. Okay. Use of non-dimensional parameters to characterize the turbo machine. Okay. We try to do this. So when I speak of non-dimensional parameters, maybe if you go back and see your what we call it as non-dimensional numbers using your Buckingham Pi method, you might have studied in your fluid mechanics. Okay. What we try to do actually, we try to see some of the variables or parameters. Variables are some of the parameters used in your, maybe in your turbo machines. What are the things? What we try to do. So you speak of variables or parameters in turbo machines, which are very significant. The first thing is the diameter of the wheels or the diameter of the turbo machine. So diameter of the machine becomes significant for it. So I go with the symbol D, and what will be its unit actually? It is a length, that is in meters. So what is the unit actually? It is meters. So it is meters, the unit, and in terms of non-dimensional, I'll go with it's a length unit. Okay. Now the second parameter, it is the quantity of the fluid that's going in. That is, we call it as discharge of the machine. So we go by Q, that is the symbol what we use, and the dimensional unit is meter cube per second. And if I want to express in terms of non-dimension, it is L cube to the power of minus 1. Fine, this is my non-dimensional thing. So when I speak of the other parameter, that is speed of the machine, the speed of the turbo machine. So the symbol what I use is N, its unit is either RPM or RPS. So its time or non-dimensional thing will be T to power of, so revolutions per minute, that's why T to power of minus 1, or revolutions per second or revolutions per minute. So when I have the fluid, it is expressed in terms of quantity, in terms of head of the fluid. So head of the fluid with the symbol H, okay, and its dimensional, it is meters, and non-dimensional, I'm going to express in terms of L. So when I'm trying to handle the fluid, it has to be real. So all real fluids will be have some kind of a density. So one of the fluid properties, density of the fluid is one more variable. Okay, one more variable. So it's, I'm going to use rho as the, it's a symbol, and it has a unit kg per meter cube, and the non-dimensional is actually it is m L to the power of minus 3. Okay, then when I speak of density, I need to speak of its corresponding viscosity effect, all those things. So your dynamic viscosity is one more term which we need to look into that. That is your mu, right? And it has a unit Newton second per meter square or Pascal second, and its non-dimensional thing will be m L to the power of minus 1 T to the power of minus 1. You can verify this. Okay, then we have another two more terms, two to three more terms which are very important here. One is the power. The seventh one is the power. We try to express anything, but it's a capacitor to do work, all those things we try to do. So the symbol what we use is P, and its unit is watts or joules per second or watts. Its non-dimensional will be m L square T to the power of minus 3. Okay. Then we have two more variables. One is acceleration due to gravity. That is your g. It has a unit of meters per second square because its acceleration, and its corresponding non-dimensional is actually L T to the power of minus 2. Okay. And we have the one more term which is not that much considered in case of a maybe some kind of a compressible turbo machines, all those things. It is very important whenever I'm trying to deal with some kind of a solid mechanics, or we call it as maybe elasticity and all. So we have one more term, which is your, we call it as Young's modulus, the coefficient of elasticity. So which is once again your Young's modulus, that is E. What is the unit? Actually, it is Newton per meter square. It has a unit or non-dimensional thing, which is ML T to power of ML to the power of minus 1 T to the power of minus 2. So these are the main quantities what we have. Okay. Now, one of the variable, I have two variables I can combine. So what we try to do is actually most of the thing here we are learning, analyzing G and H is combined as a single variable. So G and H, see, out of 9, so two variables are combined, then how many number of variables I have? If I call that as M as the number of variables available, M is equal to 8. What are my primary variables? It is length, mass and time. So it is 3. So the number of 5 terms. So the number of pi terms, it is actually, it is 8 minus 3, it is 5. So I have 5 pi terms which need to be calculated. Then as per my Buckingham pi theorem, I need to choose the repeating variables. What are the repeating variables? One should be based on the dimension. One should be another property which is based on the kinetics. And one should be a fluid property. If all those things are considered, what are the repeating variables? From the fluid property, I can take rho. And from the dimension, I can take d. And from the other kinematics, I can take it as n. So I'm going to choose rho, d, n as my repeating variables. Okay. Now, already you are aware of Buckingham pi theorems. Okay. As part of the turbo machines, you are not supposed to do that particular thing in this class. What I can do is actually you can try this at home. Use little bit of your Buckingham pi theorem knowledge and try to get this pi terms. Solve for this pi terms. Solve for pi 1, pi 2, pi 3, pi 4, and pi 5 as homework. as homework you try.
So what I want to do is actually I want to give these pi terms. When I try to solve it, these are the pi terms I'm going to get. So pi 1 is equal to your, if I try to solve, this will be, if I take it as rho d n as repeating variables, rho d n. So if I take q as one of the variable, if I take my pi 1 will be a term q by n t cube. So this is my discharge coefficient. Look at this. I do have the q. If it is based on q, actually, it is discharge coefficient. If I take the second term, that is your pi 2, which is rho a d have same c n have c. So if I call this as a1, b1, c1, if I call this as a2, b2, c2, so this is g and h. It has one more variable. If I take, actually, this will be pi 2 is equal to g into h divided by n square d square. So I have the h quantity here, so this becomes the head coefficient because of the h. So this becomes the head coefficient. Now if I have one more term, that is your pi 3, if I take rho to the power of a3, b to the power of b3, n to the power of c3, and if I take the term that is mu, so this will become pi 3 is equal to mu divided by rho n d square, or what is n into d? N into d is your u. See, n into d, see, if I take n into d as u, this will become rho into u into d, or I am going to get 1 upon rho u d by mu, or this will be 1 upon re. So n into d is your velocity. Pi d n by 60, you might be aware of it. Pi d n by 60, pi and 60 are constant. So d into n is your u. It's a function of your velocity. So what I want to get, I have one more term, that is your pi 3 term, which is 1 upon your Reynolds number. Okay. Then we have the one more term, that is your pi 4, rho a to the power of 4, b b to the power of 4, that is then n c to the power of c4. Then I'm going to take the power, that is p. So I'm going to end up with pi 4 is equal to p divided by rho n cube d to the power of 5, and this is called as your the power coefficient. This is called as a power coefficient. And we have one more pi 5 term, which is very much important in case of the solid mechanics when you are dealing with. See, this rho a 5 d b 5 n c 5 and you have e, I'm going to end up with pi 5 is equal to e divided by rho n square d square, or e by rho divided by n square d square, and this is called as the compressibility factor. This is called as compressibility factor. And this compressibility factor is used whenever I'm trying to deal with some kind of a machines where your solid mechanics comes into picture. But in case of this kind of turbo machines, actually, we won't use this compressibility factor. We'll be speaking on to discharge coefficient, head coefficient, and power coefficient. Any Reynolds number automatically comes into picture when we try to look into the type of fluid, whether it's a turbulent flow or it's a laminar kind of flow. What type of flow? Fine. This is about your 5 different non-dimensional numbers and its coefficients, what we are named it actually. So let's try to discuss actually. Discussion on these numbers. Now if I take the pi 1, what is it actually? It is your discharge coefficient q by nd cube. So let me try to modify this little bit actually. So if I take q by d square divided by n into d. What is q by d square? That means if I take, what is my q actually? Q is equal to a into velocity. What is a? It's actually is pi d square by 4, right? Pi d square. Right? Pi by 4 is constant. If I take d square, so q becomes proportional to your d and your d square and v. Or I can write, I can clearly write that v, what is there in this particular q by d square? This is your fluid velocity. What is n into d? It is your blade velocity or rotor velocity or vane velocity. Rotor or blade velocity. So I'm going to bring a relationship between your fluid velocity and your rotor velocity. So I can, so this is u is equal to n into d because it is pi d n by 16. So with that into consideration, q is proportional to your u into d square. So what will happen here? If I take the first term here, so what will happen when I speak of this kind of a thing? Your v1 is proportional to u because pi actually. It is v by u. So your pi is a constant term. So what is v actually? V is proportional to your q, which may lead to what is called as your q. Q is proportional to your nd cube or nd square into d. So I'm trying to build a relationship between your q, v, all those things and all. Or I can write q is proportional to your v square into d square. Why it is so? If you take q is equal to a into v, this is all for a little bit of discussions, that is pi d square by 4 into v. That means what does it tell? It is q is proportional to your d square v or v d square, whatever it may be. Now when I have u is proportional to v, I can write q is proportional to your u d square. Either I can write v d square or u d square. So whatever way I can write it, it is v d square or u d square. Then what is your v actually? But your fluid velocity is given by this expression, root 2 gh. Or I can write b square is equal to 2 gh or 2g is a constant, I can write v square is proportional to h or h is proportional to v square. What is v? V is q by d square. Or I can write, what is q? Q is nd cube. If I try to write the same thing, so v square is equal to h, or I can write, what is v? It is q by, so q square by, so q by d square is your v whole square is proportional to your h. Okay, what is q? I can write it as nd cube by d square whole square is proportional to your h. Or I can write, this will be nd square. So it is nd to the power of 5 divided by d to the power of 4. This will be nd square, which is proportional to your h, sorry, n square d square. Or I can write, what is h actually? H is proportional to your v. Or the finally I can write H is proportional to your U square, which is proportional to your V square, fine, which is proportional to your N square D square. So these are the ways we can try to show the relationship between your head, fluid velocity, blade velocity, all those things I can show only using the discharge. So why this particular thing, so much of discussion, why it is so much required is actually, Pi1 is your discharge coefficient, which is related to fluid velocity and the blade velocity. There is a relationship between them, where I can relate with respect to the head, where I can relate with respect to the corresponding U, that is your blade velocity, or its corresponding diameter, all the things I can try to build a relationship between them. Okay. Now, second quantity. That is, your pi2 is equal to your gh by n square d square. That is your head coefficient. Or I can write, this is gh divided. What is nd? It is u. Why it is? Because u is equal to pi d n by 60. So your pi and you have the 60, they are constant. So u is proportional to dn. I can write this as u square. Or what is already we have seen? What is u? Already you have seen u is equal to your q by d square by your pi 1. Already we have seen what is u from your first coefficient. So what is this? Clearly it tells that q by d square by pi 1 is your kinetic energy. See, this is the numerator quantity is the available head. Let me call it as available head. This is your available head divided by your kinetic energy. This is your kinetic energy. So your pi 2 shows that what is the head available with respect to the fluid, to the kinetic energy of that given fluid. That's about your second coefficient. That is your pi 2, or head coefficient. Maybe third one, that is your power coefficient, that is pi 4, that is P divided by rho into n cube d to the power of 5 is equal to P divided by, see, n cube d to the power of 5, I can write it as n cube d cube as one term and d square as one more term. So I can write it as P divided by rho into u cube d square. Okay. Now, P divided by rho, you have d cube as d square as it is. I can write u cube as rho by your d square divided by your pi 1 whole cube. So what is it actually? In the numerator, if I take, it is the power available. What is there in the denominator? Denominator, you have to the right hand side, already we have seen it is kinetic energy. To the left hand side, I have the density. That's how you can analyze it. See, for a given power available, now I'm going to change the fluid from water to something else. So I'll be able to, what is the power available? What I can power, I can produce for the given kinetic energy if I change my fluid from A to B, B to C. So those five kind of studies we can do without actually doing the experiment. Okay. So these three coefficients, that is your discharge coefficient, head coefficient, and your power coefficient will try to build a relationship between your velocity of the fluid, your blade velocity, your diameter, your density, the kinetic energy, your power available, the head available, and all those things, and kinetic energy with the power. So when you're trying to look into this aspect, so we'll be able to come up with some numbers, and that numbers are very, very significant in case of atomic machines. Okay. Continuing with the same model studies, there are certain unit quantities which we have to study. That is unit quantities which you have to study. So one such quantity is your unit speed. One such quantity is unit speed, that is n suffix u. Okay, n suffix u. What is it actually? It is the speed of a turbine. It is the speed of a turbine working under unit head of the working fluid of the given working fluid. Look at this. What is very important here? It is the speed and its head available. Okay. Let me take the pi 1. Pi 1 is equal to, it is your velocity of the fluid to your blade velocity. So what is it actually? My u is proportional to v, or I can write v is proportional to u. So whatever the way you want, you can write it. Now what is this actually? V actually, already we have seen, v is proportional to root 2gh, and a 2g is constant. I can write in terms of height. I can write, because of this quantity, I can write v is proportional to u, which is proportional to your root h. Okay. So what about your speed? Because when my u is proportional to your u is proportional to your n. Why it is so? U is equal to pi d n by 60. So u is proportional to your n. So because of that, I can write v is proportional to your u, which is proportional to your n, which is proportional to your h. I am trying to build a relationship between your velocities and all. So now your unit quantity I am going to state with respect to n and h. If I take n is proportional to h, so I can write, or if I want to remove the proportionality quantity, I can write n is equal to some constant c1 into root h. If I call that as some equation number 1, let me call that as equation number 1. So what is the definition of the unit speed actually? If the speed of this is the speed of the turbine working under unit head, okay. So what is this actually? At h is equal to 1, your speed is equal to unit speed. That's the meaning of it. So from the equation, when n is equal to nu c1, and what is the other side of it? H is equal to 1. So your h is equal to 1. When h is equal to 1, n is equal to nu. So what will happen to your c1? So c1 becomes nu. So into 1. So your nu becomes c1. Or I can write, if I call this as 2. So if I substitute in equation number 1. So substituting in equation 1, what we are going to get? We are going to get n is equal to nu into root h, or nu is equal to n by root h. This is my equation for your specific, sorry, unit speed. That means it is the nu is equal to n by root h. If I know the speed of the turbo machine, if I know the head of that particular turbo machine, I'll be able to calculate the unit speed. So this may be the, this is got mainly because of the relationship between pi 1, pi 2, what not we do that. So similarly, we have one more term. We have another term which is called as unit discharge. which is QU, which is QU. Okay. When I speak of QU, what is it actually? It is defined as, it is the discharge, it is the discharge from a turbo machine working under unit head, working under unit head of the working fluid. So you are also very important. So I do have the discharge, I do have the head. So now, when I speak of discharge, Q is equal to your area into its velocity. Fine, the velocity is nothing but your flow velocity, whatever it may be. So that means your Q is proportional to your velocity, and already we know that your V is proportional to your H. I can write Q is proportional to your velocity, which is proportional to H actually, because your V is equal to root 2G H. So now I can write Q is proportional to your H, or I can write, if I remove the proportionality constant, I can write Q is equal to C2 into root H. Let me call that as an equation number 4. Under unit head condition, that means at H is equal to 1, your Q is equal to unit discharge. So if that is the case, that what will happen? Q is equal to Q2, C2, then this is equal to 1. So my C2 is equal to QU. If I substitute in equation 4, what we are going to get actually, Q is equal to QU into root H, or my QU is equal to Q by root H. So this is my expression for your unit discharge. So we have one more term similarly, that is unit power. That is P suffix U. So it is the power developed. It is the power developed by the turbo machine working under unit head of the working fluid. Working under unit head of the working fluid, whatever it means. You are also look at it, this power under unit head. So already we have seen that. So this will be the expression P is equal to omega QH, or I can write your Q is proportional to your H already. So I can write P is proportional to Q into H, but your Q is proportional to root H. I can write this as P is proportional to H, root H and H. I can write P is proportional to H to the power of 3 by 2. Okay. Or I can write P is equal to some constant C3 H to the power of 3 by 2. Let me call that as an equation number 7. Now under unit head, that is at H is equal to 1, your power P is equal to PU. Or I can write P is equal to PU, C3 into 1 to the power of 3 by 2, it is 1. So my constant C3 is equal to PU. So substitute in the equation 7, we are going to get P is equal to PU H to the power of 3 by 2, or PU is equal to P by h to the power of 3 by 2. So we have defined clearly what is unit power, what is unit discharge, and what is unit speed. So these three things are very, very, very important for us to understand the concept of turbo machines. So we have one more thing which is called as specific speed. We have one more concept which is called as a specific speed. What is this specific speed? See, when I speak of the sum of the non-dimensional numbers, say it is a head coefficient or power coefficient or discharge coefficient, you can see that there is a term called as diameter. If I'm able to get something out of it which is independent of the size of the turbo machine, so if I define any non-dimensional number, so I have what is called as specific speed of turbo machine. So what is the specific speed of a turbo machine? If I'm able to have anything which is independent of the size, that is your diameter. If I'm able to eliminate the diameter in case of turbine or in case of a compressor, if I come up with some kind of a non-dimensional number or in terms of dimensional number, whatever it may be, that is called as your specific speed. If you take for a turbine, what is it actually? It is defined by NST. So what we are going to take actually here, I am going to take two dimensional number, that is your power coefficient and your head coefficient. The power coefficient and head coefficient I am going to take for a turbine. And for a compressor, what we take actually, if I take go for compressor, that is NSP, it is called as power producing pump or compressor, whatever it may be, I am going to take the discharge coefficient and your head coefficient. Let me write that. What is it actually? It is power coefficient is P divided by rho n cube d to the power of 5 divided by gh divided by n square t square. This is your NST. Your NST, if I look into that, it is q by n d cube divided by gh divided by n square t square. Now I want to eliminate this actually, both in the denominator and denominator. So what should I do here actually? So if I try to raise it to the power of half, here if I raise it to the power of 5 by 4, automatically the d will just vanish. So here, if I try to raise it by half, and here if I try to raise it by 3 by 4, the d will simply vanish in both numerator and denominator. You can do that simple exercise. So what will happen? It is 5 by 2, here it is d to the power of, look at this, d square is there. Automatically it is 4, so 5 by 2. So in both numerator and denominator, it becomes d to the power of 5 by 2, d to the power of 5 by 2. Here it will be d to the power of 3 by 2, here also d to the power of 3 by 2. If I do the simple mathematical calculations and try to eliminate it actually, I am going to get a number. So this will become NST is equal to P to the power of half divided by, this is, I do have rho to the power of half root to power of half n to power of 3 by 2, okay, that is in the numerator, divided by g to the power of 5 by 4 h to the power of 5 by 4 divided by n to the power of 5 by 2 here, yeah, this side. Similarly, I will get the here also, I am going to get, it is q to the power of half divided by n to the power of 1 by 2, the whole thing divided by g to the power of 3 by 4, h to the power of 3 by 4 divided by n to the power of, so that is 6 by 4, that is 3 by 2. So all these things I am going to get in this fashion. So n to the power of 3 by 2, n to the power of half, I am going to get n actually. I am going to get n. So if I try to do the simplification, I am going to get nst. This is equal to, if I take n to the numerator from the denominator to the numerator, n to the power of 5 by 2 minus 3 by 2, if I do that, I am going to get, take root of it and all, I am going to get, it will be simply n, it will be root p. You can do that simple exercise, n root p divided by g h to the power of 5 by 4 here. So here I am going to get nsp is equal to n root q divided by g h to the power of 3 by 4. So this is the non-dimensional form of specific speed, where your n, see, this is your n is in radians per second. So this particular n is in radians per second. Suppose the same quantity I want to express in terms of dimensional form. The same quantity I can write it as n root p divided by h to the power of 5 by 4, where I am going to eliminate the g quantity and your n is in revolutions per minute or revolutions per second. Here also it is n root q divided by h to the power of 3 by 4. This is n is in RPM. So we have one in non-dimensional form and you have another term in terms of non, maybe dimensional form. I think in your turbo machine slab you have the dimensional form, n root p by h to the power of 5 by 4 for a Pelton wheel, for a Francis turbine, or n root q by h to the power of 3 by 4 for a centrifugal pump or a compressor. We try to find these non-dimensional numbers. Okay. Now, maybe in the, I think we'll try to end here. Maybe in the next class, we'll try to look into this.